In this lecture, we are going to discuss about how to find a degree of freedom for a given mechanism. So far, we discussed different terminologies used in mechanism, and this one, degree of freedom, is very, very important because the degree of freedom says the complexity of the mechanism. There are many ways you can design a mechanism for an application. So say, for example, you have an application and you want to design a mechanism for that application. So you can design a mechanism in different ways. You make it for a different mechanism which solve the same purpose. But how do you choose the best one? So there are some parameter. One of the parameter should be degree of freedom. So the degree of freedom should be as less as possible, because the degree of freedom says the complexity. If the degree of freedom is 1, then it is less complex. If the degree of freedom is high, then there is a complexity involved. If there is a complexity involved in the mechanism, then it will be very difficult to control. So the total aim is to keep the degree of freedom as less as possible. And let us consider the four bar mechanism. Here the degree of freedom of four bar mechanism is 1, so that 1 represents theta. If you know the crank angle, you can easily find the position of all the four links, because the length of the link is constant, so that we can find the position of all link with the help of crank angle. Here the theta represents degree of freedom. Here it is 1. Similarly, the degree of freedom of slider crank mechanism also 1. So here again theta represent crank angle. If you know the crank angle of crank, we can easily find the position of connecting rod, slider, then fixed link. So this is what the slider crank, the degree of freedom says about slider crank mechanism. See, let us see how to find degree of freedom for different mechanism. So that is what we are going to discuss in this lecture. Let us start with definition. Degree of freedom is defined as a number of input parameter which must be independently controlled. Say, for example, in four bar mechanism, theta is considered as number of independent parameters. So here it is 1, which must be independently controlled to bring the mechanism into useful purpose. Let us consider a simple link. A link has 3 degree of freedom. It can move along x direction, y direction, then theta. So any link on so any planar mechanism has 3 degree of freedom. So planar means 2D elements. So in 2D element, it has 3 degree of freedom. The moment you fix this link like this, the degree of freedom is 0, because it cannot move on x, y, theta direction. Okay, so a link has maximum of 3 degree of freedom. Okay, so like that you can find degree of freedom for any arrangement. Let us see the formula. So this is a formula to find degree of freedom. N equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. Here L represent number of link, J represent number of joint, H represent number of higher pair, namely gear or cam arrangement. Okay, so with this help, we can find degree of freedom of four bar mechanism. So this is a four bar mechanism. Four bar mechanism has 4 link, then it has 4 joint, 2, 3, 4. So 3 into 4 minus 1 minus 2 into 4 joint, there is no higher pair. So 3 into 3 minus 2 into 4. So the degree of freedom of 4 bar mechanism 1. So this is how we can find degree of freedom using this formula. Here that 1 represent crank angle theta. So the degree of freedom says that if you know the crank angle of 4 bar mechanism, you can find all the parameters of four bar mechanism. So that is the meaning of degree of freedom. The degree of freedom says the complexity of the mechanism. If the degree of freedom is 0, then it is not mechanism, it's a structure, there is no movement. If the degree of freedom is 1, This is called simple mechanism. If the degree of freedom is 2, 3, 4 like that, there is an increase of complexity. So for the 4-bar mechanism is an example for simple mechanism because it has only 1 degree of freedom. So this formula is known as Gauss-Bach criterion. So with the help of Gauss-Bach criterion, you can find the degree of freedom of a mechanism. Okay, so let me derive the formula. So n equal to 3l minus 1 minus 2j h. How this formula arrived? So we can derive. Okay, so number of link in a mechanism, say we take same 4-bar mechanism, 1 2 3 4, there are 4 links. We can take that 4 as l. Okay, the next condition, number of movable link. Here in a in order to be a mechanism, at least any one of the link should be fixed. So here number of movable link 3, which means l minus 1. Okay, you take any arrangement, it has l number of link, but the number of movable link should be l minus 1, because the definition of mechanism says that any one of the link should be fixed. So we are taking l minus 1 link as a movable link in mechanism. Okay, the next step, maximum degree of freedom of movable link. As I said already, any link on planar space has maximum 3 degree of freedom. Say for example, you take a link like this, this is 3. I can move 3 on x direction, y direction, then theta direction. So each link has 3 degree of freedom. So maximum degree of freedom of movable link, I already have l minus 1 link, so 3 into l minus 1. So this is the maximum degree of each movable link. Then comes the next question, maximum degree of freedom of mechanism. Say for example, I have totally 4 link, 1 2 3 4. The degree of freedom of 1 0, the degree of freedom of 2 3, degree of freedom of 3 3, degree of freedom of 4 3. So each link has separately has maximum 3 degree of freedom, which means I can move link to x, y and theta direction, similarly 3 and 4. But the moment I connect 1 and 2, what will happen? This is turning pair. The moment I connect 1 and 2, what will happen? I can do only rotation about 1. So 3 possibilities of degree of freedom reduced into 1. Okay, so 3 reduced into 1, which means minus 2. So that's why I put minus 2j. Whenever 2 links are connected by a turning pair, then the reduction is minus 2j from 3. Again, 3 has 3 degree of freedom. Okay, the moment I connect 2 and 3, it has only one possibility, theta 1. I can only rotate. So 3 degree of freedom reduced into 1 degree of freedom. So 3 minus 2. That's why I put 2j. So whenever a join, a turning join connected between 2 link, then the reduction of degree of freedom minus 2, minus 2j. So 3 reduced into 1, which means 3 minus 2. That's why I am putting 2j. Here there is no higher pair, but if there is a higher pair, then the reduction will be minus 1. Okay, so this is how we can derive this formula. So maximum degree of freedom of a mechanism, n equal to 3l minus 1 minus 2j minus h. So there is no need to remember this formula. You can easily understand this formula based on this logic. 3 into l minus 1 minus 2j minus h. So each has some meaning. Say here 3 represent maximum degree of freedom of each link, minus 1 represent one link fixed, minus 2 represent each joint reduce 2 degree of freedom. H represent higher power. So this is how we can remember the Goodsbatch criterion of a mechanism. So N equal to 3L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. Suppose there is a condition called Grubler criterion, which applies to a mechanism with 1 degree of freedom. We call it as simple mechanism. So apply N equal to 1 here, then you can reduce this equation like this. So N equal to 1, so 1 equal to 3L minus 1 minus 2J, there is no higher power, we can take that value as 0. So it will be reduced as 3L minus 2J minus 4 equal to 0. So this equation is known as Grubler criterion, which has to be satisfied for a mechanism with 1 degree of freedom. So this is a condition to be satisfied for a mechanism with 1 degree of freedom. So you can verify this for 4 bar mechanism. 4 bar mechanism has 4 link, then 4 bar mechanism has 4 joint minus 4 equal to 0. So 12 minus 8 minus 4. So 12 minus 8 minus 4, 0. So this is true. So 4 bar mechanism has only 1 degree of freedom. So Grubler criterion is a condition to be satisfied for mechanism with 1 degree of freedom. So let us find degree of freedom of different arrangement. So totally have 5 arrangement. Arrangement 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So let us take arrangement 1. It's a triangular shape. We normally see the this kind of structure on bridge. Okay, they will not, even in the roof also they will use this kind of structure, triangular. By default, triangular represent equilibrium. It's an example for structure. So when you find the degree of freedom for a structure or arrangement like triangle, you will get 0. So this is a basic concept. We can verify this using that formula. N equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J. Again, H equal to 0 for all the arrangements. Number of link 1, 2, 3. So 3 into 3 minus 1 minus 2 into number of joint 1, 2, 3. So 2 into 3. So 3 into 2 minus 2 into 3 equal to 0. So this is an example for structure. As I said already, so wherever you find a triangular shape, it represent structure. For example, the degree of freedom of structure is equal to 0 based on this formula. Let us find the degree of freedom. So what is this 4 bar mechanism? We already calculated the degree of freedom of 4 bar mechanism using 3L minus 1 minus 2J. So 3 into number of link 4, 4 minus 1 minus number of joint 4 minus 2 into 4. So 3 into 3, 9 minus 2 into 4, 8. So 9 minus 8, 1. So degree of freedom 1. So this is an example for simple mechanism. Okay, so let us find the degree of freedom of arrangement 3. Here we have 5 links. So N equal to L equal to 5. So for this condition, L equal to 5. Then joined 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So joined also 5. So put 3 into 5 minus 1 minus 2 into 5. Okay, so 12 minus 10 degree of freedom 2. So this is a complex mechanism because degree of freedom more than 1. Let us take this arrangement. Okay, so again this is 4 bar mechanism plus one additional link. We are adding an additional link. So which will give stability. Okay, so let us find the degree of freedom. So here number of link 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for the next problem, number of link 5, then number of joint. See here, there is a difference. Two links are connected at this point, here and here. Whereas here, three links are connected. Okay, so this is an example for ternary joint. So one ternary joint equal to two binary joint. So totally there are two binary joint, B and D. So 1 plus 1, 2. Again here this is ternary. One ternary equal to two binary. Again here this is ternary, so one ternary joint equal to two binary. So for total this is one binary, here one binary, one here 2b, so 1 plus 2 3, 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 2 6. So number of link here 6, number of joint, so number of joint 6. So 3 into 5 minus 1, so 3 into 4 minus 2 into 6, so this is equal to 0. Again this is an example for structure. So when you connect a diagonal element for 4 bar mechanism, this is 4 bar, the difference between these two, we are adding a diagonal element, then the degree of freedom should be 0. So let us solve the last one, last arrangement. Okay, again it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, there is no connection here. Okay, so totally there are 6 links for the last problem, there are 6 links. Then joint, one, this is one ternary joint, second ternary joint, third ternary joint, fourth ternary joint. So there are 4 ternary joint. One ternary joint equal to 2 binary joint. So totally 8 joint, 8 binary joint. So L equal to 6, joint equal to 8. So 3 into 6 minus 1, 15, 2 into 8. So you will get 3 into 5, 15, minus 2 into 8, minus 1. So that minus 1 represent indeterminate structure. Because you see here, what is the difference between 4 and 5? Very simple, both are same except we are adding one link like this. Okay, this is the extra link. So here I have 4 bar mechanism. One, when you add one diagonal element to 4 bar mechanism, you will get this mechanism. If you add one more diagonal element, you will get this mechanism. Here the degree of freedom 1. Once you add diagonal element, this should be 0 degree of freedom. But hereafter we are adding one more extra structure. So whenever you get a degree of freedom minus 1, which means there is an extra element added to the arrangement. See, there is no need to add this element. The moment you add a link 5 at A to C, you will get 0 degree of freedom. That's it. So there is no need to go beyond that. But we are adding extra element 6 between D to B. So that is an extra element. That's why we are getting minus 1. So that extra element 6 is nothing but indeterminate structure. So sometimes when you design a mechanism, you may get a degree of freedom of minus 1, which represent that there is an extra element in your mechanism. So this is how you can find degree of freedom of different planar mechanism without considering the higher pair. So we have solved without considering higher pair. So you have to remember this condition. One ternary joint equal to two binary joint. And again one quaternary joint equal to three binary joint. So this is a condition you have to remember. So this is how you can find and a degree of freedom of different mechanisms using Gauss-Bach criterion. Thanks for watching my video.